Hello, Norbert here, energy engineer, and explain in video number 38 the significance of phase change materials, PCM, and how it can benefit you. I introduced this last Wednesday, and bought a specific environmentally friendly PCM, phase change material, which was an alternative to the paraffin from fossil oil. This material had a lower melt point than I expected, but still it is very useful to show to you how you can use it to come through the cold months by making this PCM into an energy storage, like a thermal battery. Phase change materials or PCM are much more convenient to store thermal energy than expensive electrical batteries, as long as we talk about not storing heat or cold. Knowing about these tricks, about these energy tricks, is really crucial for a better future. Subscribe to this channel to learn about the hidden facts and possibilities of energy, and prepare for the future, which certainly will bring legislation for more austerity with energy. Watch also tomorrow, Sunday, my educational video about PCM. It is the second of a series of educational videos of each less than 2 minutes for a long series to come. Let's start with a very simple PCM, which we all know. It is water. When ice of 0 degrees Celsius is molten to become all water at still 0 degrees, it takes a significant amount of energy to make this change of phase. This amount of energy is so large that it is enough to heat up this molten water from 0 degrees to 80 degrees. Same amount of water. Well, now you can ask, where has this energy gone if there is no temperature rise? And the answer is that it has been invested, this energy, into more freedom for the water molecules from solid ice to fluid water. It's maybe the same like paying the police for getting out someone of jail. Although the phase remains equal, the phase has changed. And as we saw, this phase change requires a lot of energy for water, but also for wax. It is more or less the same to melt wax, to heat it up, to heat the liquid wax 80 degrees more. But once molten, this wax, it will keep its temperature of 40 degrees for a long time, even when you extract heat from it. And this is of course very useful for you, because while a bag of warm water, which we all know, it gives heat, yes, but while it gives heat, it quickly decreases in temperature. This change of phase, it allows that the temperature remains at this 40 degrees, which is about 15 degrees higher than the normal temperature of your skin, that it stays at that comfortable temperature for all the time that not all the wax has been changed into the solid state. And that's of course exciting, because it is like a battery that you give energy into it, you invest it in it, and then it gives this energy back, but staying at 40 degrees Celsius. And that's quite interesting, because what is then the difference between this phase change material and a battery, other than the type of energy? Well, nothing. Because if you see how a battery works, you take from a battery electrical energy, but the voltage stays more or less at, let's say for a car battery, at 12 volt. Even when you take all the energy, the battery will go below 12 volt. And that's the same with the PCM. The only difference between water and wax is that the water has a very definite point of melting. It's 0 degrees, and then it goes from really solid to very fluid. And with the wax, it becomes first soft and then it becomes more liquid. There are indeed many types of wax, and I bought the soya wax, which has this melting point of 40 degrees. There are also wax types, I think up to 70 degrees, for example, keeping hot food and drink, but also, for example, increasing the capacity, the heat capacity of your water tank. Anyway, to understand a little bit better how this wax behaves around this point of 40 degrees. I wanted to experiment myself because I didn't find so much on the internet. But let me tell about my first experience. I read that I could put it in the microwave, and my first impression was very good because I needed for a little jar maybe 250 grams, but even less because there's a hole in it. It's partly empty, so let's say 200 grams. And I needed not less than 5 minutes to make it all liquid. And with milk, for example, a quarter of a liter, and that gets hot in 1.5 minutes. So that was already a good sign and the first confirmation that really this is taking a lot of energy to get this just molten. But okay, microwave is electric, and I prefer to melt this wax with a cheaper form of energy. So I put this in a pot of water, and then this pot of water I put on a gas flame, and I can control very well the temperature of the water, which is here around. So here I show the results of that. So as I said, I can control the temperature of the water. Another thermometer is here in the wax. The outside temperature of the water is still 87, 86 degrees. And of the wax, it doesn't go beyond 42 degrees. Here you see the wax, which starts at 72.4, and the water, it's 700 milliliter, more or less the same weight as this 750 milliliter of wax. Well, the water has the more or less double heat capacity, so it's 4.2 joules per Kelvin per gram. And with the wax, it is more or less the half. We see here that the blue line of the water is going continuously down. So that would be the water back, the normal water. And the wax is the yellow line, and at a minute 40, it comes at a constant point of 47 degrees or so. And there it stays for 100 minutes, so for more than 1.5 hours. It is true that the water started at a higher point at 90 degrees, because if it also started at 72 degrees like the wax, it would now be at 20 degrees at the end, much lower than the wax. But it's also realistic that the water is filled in the water bag at 90 degrees, even if it can be a little bit dangerous. What is really disappointing from the wax is that this temperature is the average temperature between the center and the wall of the container of wax. And that means the temperature which is here is more or less 5 degrees above the wall temperature, and that is what you feel. So on the touch, it is also in comparison with the water, the wax, the big wax container is disappointing, even if it's good that it is still staying so long time at constant temperature. My solution would be that there must not be a big distance between the core of the container and the wall, so that means we need small containers or very thin. So okay, these experiments, what do they bring for you? You can put wax in glass containers like here, or also in plastic, as long as this plastic is can withstand higher temperatures. Okay, the water which I where I put this in, or the plastic bottle, is not so hot. You don't have to boil it. Okay, and for those applications, you need something like 1 kilo or 2 kilos. That's normal, because also a normal warm water bag is more or less between 1 and 2 liter. And for body heating on the go, you can take multiple small bottles, for example those for soap or for fruit juice or for yogurt, and then you can more of them you can bring with you and put them on your body. You can also use aluminium cans, but this one is long and slender, so it's good. But if you fill them up with wax, then you have also to seal them so that it can't go out anymore. So if, for example, you turn it, it will not leak. Okay, so like I said before, you have batteries with different voltages, and in the same way, PCMs can have different melting temperatures. So the melting temperatures are a little bit comparable with the voltage of electrical battery, because that's the point, that's the parameter which remains constant while you take out the energy. So this wax which I bought is okay for the body. It is 15 degrees above the skin temperature, but for keeping warm food or drink, maybe as I said, the water storage in your house to give it a higher heat capacity, you need the wax of other temperatures. And yeah, for now I know about waxes of 70 degrees which you can normally buy. I imagine that there are also temperatures, PCMs at many other temperatures. So for example, they use them also for the house. They put them under together with the insulation material of the house, so those will certainly have other temperatures, melting temperatures. Because I'm particularly interested in keeping food or drink warm, or to increase the capacity of a hot water boiler, and I think that 70 degrees is very interesting, so I want to buy stearic acid, and I will keep you informed about my experiences there. And I will also build things which are useful for you, and then I will tell you how you can build them and make them useful. Yes, it's true, energy storage is very important, and many experts they agree that energy storage in all its forms are crucial for the success of renewable energy, and also to address the problem of variable demand.
What can I do after seeing this video?
Well, I think that during winter it's important to keep your body warm. It's better to give your body 5 degrees more than give the house even 1 degree more. That would really save you much energy if you did that. Please like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. I would really like to make this a full-time job and help you do it yourself to keep your energy situation under control. Good energy to you.